Good evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome to our celebration of Mass this evening. It's the fifth Sunday in ordinary time. We are journeying on a path of discipleship with Matthew's Gospel this year, and we were given in the Beatitudes, beginning of chapter 5, Jesus' agenda, and he makes it a little more precise tonight about how we might be part of that project, what directly would be our role. And so an invitation is set before us, that it might find us open-minded and open-hearted. We pray that the word of God might encourage us, that we might celebrate the Eucharist worthily together. We call to mind our sins, asking God's pardon. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. Christ. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with your unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of your grace, we may be defended always by your protection. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, share your bread with the hungry and shelter the homeless poor. Clothe the man you see to be naked and turn not from your own kin. Then will your light shine like the dawn and your wound be quickly healed over. Your integrity will go before you and the glory of the Lord behind you. Cry and the Lord will answer. Call, and he will say, I am here. If you do away with the yoke, the clenched fist, the wicked word, if you give your bread to the hungry and relief to the oppressed, your light will rise in the darkness, and your shadows become like noon. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The good man is a light in the darkness for the upright. The good man is a light in the darkness for the upright. He is a light in the darkness for the upright. He is generous, merciful, and just. The good man takes pity and lends. He conducts his affairs with honour.
The good man is a light in the darkness
for the upright. The just man will never waver. He will be remembered forever. He has no fear of evil news. With a firm heart, he trusts in the Lord.
The good man lights in darkness for the upright.
With a steadfast heart, he will not fear. Open-handed, he gives to the poor. His justice stands firm forever. His head will be raised in glory.
The good man is a light in the darkness for the upright.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers, it was not with any show of oratory or philosophy, but simply to tell you what God has guaranteed. During my stay with you, the only knowledge I claimed to have was about Jesus, and only about him as the crucified Christ. Far from relying on any power of your own, I came among you in great fear and trembling, and in my speeches and sermons that I gave, there were none of the arguments that belong to philosophy, only a demonstration of the power of the Spirit. And I did this so that your faith should not depend on human philosophy, but on the power of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Anyone who follows me will have the light of life.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt becomes tasteless, what can make it salty again? It is good for nothing and can only be thrown out to be trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hilltop cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp to put it under a tub. They put it on the lampstand where it shines for everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine in the sight of men, so that seeing your good works, they may give the praise to your Father in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm sure many of you will be familiar with the name of Graham Greene. He was probably the 20th century's foremost English author, and he was a very devout Catholic also. So very often elements of his faith and thematics of Catholicism are found in his novels, which are kind of unfailingly entertaining, many made into movies. And he's got a series of short stories, and in one of them he tells of a man shabbily dressed down at heel with a battered suitcase checking into a small shabby hotel in New York, and he signs the register, and because he is clearly not got much money, they ask him to pay in advance, and he does that, and the clerk, the receptionist, sees him up to his room and has a look at the register to see who it is, and he says to his assistant, "Do you recognise who that man was?" And the assistant says, "No, don't know." And he says, "Actually," he said, "it's the Pope." And the plot of the story is that Catholicism is long since outlawed, and everyone admitting to being a Catholic and not denying their faith has been summarily dispatched by the firing squad, and the last remaining Catholic in the world is the Pope. And he's been summoned to New York to meet the dictator who has put in place these draconian laws and had the Catholics of the world put to death for their faith. And he decides, when the man comes to see him, when the Pope comes to see him, that he's going to kill the Pope, and he will therefore be the one who finally lays Catholicism, and indeed Christianity, as a recognisable form of faith, to rest completely. So he gets the Pope in to see him the next morning, and he sits him down in his office, and he takes out a revolver from his desk, and he decides he himself will be the one to dispatch the last Catholic, the Pope. And as he pulls the trigger, before the bullet hits its intended target, across his mind floats the thought, I wonder if what this man stood for could be true. And Graham Greene writes, in that moment of wonder, the next generation of Catholic Christian is born. He said, it's just an inquiry, just a suggestion that maybe there's something in it, but that seed is enough to prey on his mind and to have him speak of it. It's a chilling tale. It's a short story. It's supposed to be short and impactful, but it shows you something of his faith and how he understood faith to be. And I don't think he's terribly wide of the mark, because while we know what salt and light is, when Jesus uses that couplet of metaphors to talk about what discipleship is, maybe something is lost for us, because the image is, it seems obvious, but there is a complexity to it, because they don't obviously have anything in common, and nowadays they're sometimes evaluated negatively, in that we talk about light pollution being a not a good thing, and too much salt in our diets being not a good thing. But of course, in the culture of Jesus, they were both profoundly good things for what they did, and what they do is the thing that they have in common. We don't put salt on our food because we want it to taste salty. We put salt on our food so that it tastes more of what it tastes like. It gives savour to our food. And we don't normally switch on a light to look at the light. We normally switch on the light to illumine something else. So salt and light we have by virtue of what they do for other things, not by virtue of what they do and are for themselves. And Jesus uses those images about discipleship. I wonder if when people see us acting as the Beatitudes last week suggested we act, as peacekeepers, as those who hunger and thirst for justice, those who mourn with joyous heart, those who are persecuted in the cause of right, and so on and so forth. I wonder if it could be that when people see us do that, they might say, what makes that person a person of integrity, a person of honesty, a person of ethic, a person who chooses for others? And if we provoke that, if we do that for other people, we witness to our faith in a very profound and challenging way. More so, I think, than we would standing at a street corner on a soapbox shouting about the Lord Jesus. The witness of our lives, and a gentle witness, a calm witness, a quiet witness, is a powerful one. I'm thinking, just to bring it up to date for our kind of focus in these days of cost of living and poverty and the challenge of making ends meet, people might say, how is it that those people at St. Conval's are happy to provide a food parcel for me? How is it that they will willingly give something from themselves for me, someone they don't necessarily know, but just out of the goodness of their hearts? And if we provoke that, we do a powerful thing. We are salt and we are light. We exist for the good of others, for what we give, not for what we are. And what we give is so that people will give thanks to our Father in heaven. And if they do so, then they acknowledge his presence. If they acknowledge his presence, they acknowledge perhaps that he has sent his Son. If they acknowledge he has sent his Son, there is response to the command of Christ, to generosity, to forgiveness, to integrity of heart. In that, we make a new generation of Christians. For such grace, for such privilege in our lives, for each other and ourselves, we pray this evening. to pray for our needs, we stand.
Give to the church power to proclaim your great works and to shine as a light that will draw all people to love and honour your name. May your people never lose by sin or negligence the holiness which is given to all who trust in you and seek to do your work. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
As people seek their own ways and turn away from obedience, bring them to know that the law of God is strong and does not change as human fashions change. Give courage to any who have gifts which they do not know or which they have failed to use, and lead them into the light of the divine purpose fulfilled. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Bless those who do the work of God in our community, who tend the sick in mind or body, and bring aid to the infirm. May they have strength to continue, and may they be an example that others shall follow in the paths of mercy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Look with compassion in all who have lost the assurance of faith and purpose in life which they once had. May they know that they are not cast out from your love, but may be won back to the way that cannot be found by human will alone. Bless those in sickness and distress, still shine brightly in their patient trust. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Receive into glory the souls of those whose light shone as a witness in the world, and have mercy on those whose light was darkened by sin or suffering. May they too shine with a light that cannot be extinguished, and find the peace that they did not find here. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. To these general intercessions, we add prayer for our own particular and local needs. We remember those who have asked us to pray for them, especially those whom we know to be in particular need at this time. Pray for those who join us online, particularly if they are caring for others, if they are unwell, and if their care arises either within the context of family or as their vocation in life. Lord, will be with them, strengthen them, bless them for their generosity of heart. Pray for those who seek to support and educate our young people, especially we pray for the school community of St. Benedict's facing a HMI inspection. It can be a stressful time as everything is measured, everything is commented on, and everything is noted. Lord, will bless them with wisdom and with strength. And we pray for ourselves and for each other, that as those called to be salt and light, we might act in a way that enables glory to be given to God our Father. And finally, we pray for our dead. We remember those who died recently, especially Philip Sweeney and Chris Halsgrove, and those whose anniversaries occur about now, especially those we've been asked to remember in prayer. That they may all know the presence of God. Lord, hear us. God, our Father, you call us to be your people. You call us to be salt and light in your world. Give us courage to act in a way that provokes others to recognize you at work in us. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Let's stand and pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Lord God, who have given us these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant us, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of our salvation. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies, faithful God. For you have given us Christ Jesus, your Son, as our Lord and Saviour. He always showed compassion to the children and to the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and became a neighbour to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so, with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name, and we sing the hymn of your glory with all the saints, as together with them without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on our journey of life. Blessed also your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these Eucharists. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Saviour, whom you led through passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your own right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favour on this offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope, John our Bishop, bishops, priests, deacons, and the entire people you've made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire us in word and action to comfort those who labour and are overburdened. Help us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and to freedom, to peace and to justice, so that all people may be raised to new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the Apostles and Martyrs, St. Conval and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Christ Jesus, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. For the coming of God's kingdom, we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Lord God, you will that we be partakers in the one bread and the one cup. Grant us, we pray, so to live that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Our prayer we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. Can I invite you to take a copy of the bulletin or familiarise yourself with the most recent notices in all the usual ways. We prayed in particular for Philip Sweeney. His funeral will take place on Friday at 10 o'clock, and for Chris Holsgrove, her funeral a week on Tuesday, also at 10 o'clock. Thank you for your ongoing support for our food packages, a great witness to our shared faith in the gospel, to those who give money and to those who bring groceries. I'm very grateful. If you could find it in your heart or your purse or your shopping basket to pop something in and bring it down at the weekend for Mass, we'll ensure it goes into a balanced package distributed to those who are in need, and they're available in the porch. If you know anyone who would appreciate it, you're very welcome to take one for them. Thanks to those also who do the shopping and the packing to make sure they go where they need to go when they need to go there. Thanks for being here this evening. I hope you have a lovely evening and a good week too. Let's ask God's blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.